Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Big Brother Saints Amino Edition. We're going to discuss a little bit of what happened last time, which was basically that Moose won HOH and decided to nominate both Bonta and Charlie. Mondo won Power Veto, and he could choose someone to be lifted from the seat, but he kept the nominations the same. So, with that being said, one of them had to go, and by one of them, it was basically Charlie. Charlie was evicted from the Big Brother house and will no longer be participating, and we're down to our final five, Bonta, Moose, Seven, TVA, and Mondo. One of them is closer to winning the whole game, and yeah, but we're going to get into this new episode of Big Brother. And we're going to actually reveal the new house that we have for this week. Because, you know, we always change it up a little bit. This was not that big a deal. This was not that biggie. But we're going to show you either way. But this is talent week, right? So I decided to add a little bit of like an art kind of style to it. Just give it a little bit of a different thing. We also have piano over there. They're not gonna use, but if they do, then oops. We have a microphone over there as well, and outside we have a couple of mannequins that we are going to discuss in a bit, because these mannequins are prior to the competition that will be kind of done like in a few days, since Dave, but we did the competition because this was meant for you guys to vote. The votes are already in, and there's already a winner, but we're not going to reveal that until later, because we're going to make this prior to the game. So those mannequins are going to stay there for the rest of the day. Well, kind of the week, almost a week, but you'll get what I mean. Okay, you get it. Alright, so right now it's kind of late for them, so I'm just gonna let them do their thing for the night, and when it's back to the day, we're gonna discuss a little bit about them and how I feel about them in certain conditions of the game, and yeah, we're gonna talk about how they're doing in the competition. They made it to the final five, they can't be doing that bad, but I'm curious on what's gonna happen prior this week, because every week will be coming harder and harder. There's an alive with two people and another alive with two people, Moose being the only one that is left out. This week is big for the alliances. This week is gigantic for them. And Moose can't do anything about it because he already won HOH. And he's not really in the favorite spot. But he still won a good HOH competition. And he still has a chance with Veto. So he isn't really all that left out. Other than that, he should be fine. But we'll discuss that a little bit more later on. I will cut right here, and we'll see you guys then. Alright, I figured that now is a good time to discuss what the Big Brother house has been doing. But let's start with Bonta, maybe, you know, like... So with Bonta, I think... Bonta's been doing really good for herself. I think Bonta has carried her weight around the game. Played some good competitions, made some good social decisions. I think Bonta could go farther than Final Five, but that doesn't mean that she is, you know, entirely safe. And I'll get to that in a minute, but we're going to discuss a little bit of everybody's gameplay here, you know? Like, Bonta has her alliance with Seven, as we know as of now. Bonta's an alliance with Seven. They've been that like that since they, like, won, basically. They're basically workout buddies. And they've been there, like, from the very beginning. And Bonta's a threat. So she might have to watch her back and carry competitions. Like, the Veto might be important. So let's hope that Bonta pulls up her weight a little bit more if she wants to continue. Let's talk a little bit about Moose, who can't win HOH this week because he's been the previous HOH. Him winning the previous HOH, though, was very important because... He was in dangerous waters. Oh, look, Charlie's over there. Ironic. Charlie's leaving the Big Brother house. That's literally what happened. If it wasn't, it would have probably been Moose who left the house and not Charlie. Charlie would have been probably in the final five. However, that does mean Moose does need to still be aware of what's going on with his surroundings. So it's good that he's socializing with people because he needs this. He needs to communicate with these people and to connect with them. He has his target on his back and he needs to make sure that he's safe. Once he does that, he might even guarantee himself a spot on the final three. Who knows? Now let's move on to Seven. Seven, to be honest, kind of in a gray area with him now. He kind of relies a little bit on Bonta, and he does have alliances in the house, but there are people that don't like him still in the house. And that could be his downfall. And we don't know if that's going to be everlasting. I don't know if this might be his final week, or this might be his week of, hey, I'm here to win it. So I feel like this week could be very important for him, and it could actually shape the future of the Big Brother house. So this week is, I feel like, one of his most important weeks, because now I feel like he's starting to enter dangerous waters that he hasn't been on yet. But I feel like this time it could be it. Moving on to Bonta. English, bitch. Moving on to Bonta. Not Bonta, TVA. Moving on to TVA. I feel like she has done quite well for herself. I feel like she actually showed that she was the underdog in a lot of situations. She proved herself in competitions, great social skills. I feel like she could be a threat a little bit in this house. Is she safe though? Not sure. But that doesn't mean that she is entirely out of the woods yet. And last but not least, we have Mondo. Kind of a little bit with Seven. Good at competitions. Not all the competitions, but good at competitions. And really good socially. Has made some alliances in the house. Has won TVA. But I think that Mondo this week, kind of like how Seven is, needs to work it up, because this could be his final. We don't know that for sure, but we could see maybe a potential downfall on his part, maybe. But at the same time, I don't think that's entirely the case. Okay, but now comes the question. Who do I think is safe and who do I think is not? And I'm completely honest when I say this. No one is safe. No one is safe. Everybody here in this house is in dangerous waters. Backstabbings, blindsides, anything can happen now. Anything can happen now that in the Big Brother house. Bonta could leave. Moose could leave. Seven could leave. TVA could leave. Mondo could leave. Everybody here is not safe. No one is safe right now. I don't feel like anybody is safe. I feel like everybody here can suffer the consequences. And that's going to put a big, big impact. So whoever wins HOH and Veto this week, they're going to shape the future, basically. That being said, I think that the game is just going to be really tough to tell now. And I will leave it at that for now. And we're just going to let them be for the rest of the day. And we're going to move on to the next day so I can elaborate on this. And we'll get to that in a second for you. So we can explain what happened in the HOH competition. And let's see who you guys chose for the winner. So I will see you guys then. Alright, so at this point, before we even start, I'm going to show you the competition and how it happened. So that way you know who is the true winner of the challenge. And I will give you the results at the end of the video. So I will let you guys watch the thing, and then I'll tell you the results on who won the competition. So last episode, at the end of it, I told you guys to vote for a mannequin. They were customized by our contestants that were eligible to compete in the next HOH competition. So I haven't filmed that part yet. I haven't filmed any of that yet. I am here to show you the game process and how it actually happened, okay? So, what's going on right now is we're going to start off with Bonta, and I'm going to randomly select a color according to the mannequin that you guys voted for. We got red, yellow, black, and white. Pretty obvious, pretty simple, right? So I'm gonna pick it, I'm gonna press the spin the wheel thing, and we're gonna do that right here, right now. So this is how you're gonna find out who the winner is, probably, because you guys are gonna vote. At this point, you already voted for it. So the votes are in, and all that it takes is just to reveal the winner. I don't know who the winner is because I have to wait for that. The anticipation is gonna kill me. But since it's an anonymous competition, we're just gonna start it off. Moose, since you're HOH, you are not eligible to compete. The rest of the contestants are still fair game. I'm gonna start it off with Bontai. I have a wheel right now that is spinning, and it's gonna tell me what color Bontai is going to be. Bontai has chosen. Looks like it's yellow. Okay, we're gonna remove that from the wheel. And let's go to create outfit and create random outfit. And we're just gonna do it, let's just do an everyday outfit, okay? Let's start it off with an everyday outfit. So this, if you voted for yellow, you probably voted for Bontai. Let's just wait for Bontai to actually move. Let's see what Bontai actually does. Alright, that's Bonta's outfit. If you guys like that outfit the most, that's the one that you voted for. And it belongs to Bontai. Up next we have 7. Let me just fit Bontai out, and I'm gonna see what 7's going to pick next. 7 has chosen the black mannequin. I'm gonna remove that. Let's pause the game for a minute. Let's see. Free random outfit. Yep. Everyday outfit. Alright, let's see what 7. This is the outfit that you guys voted for if you voted for 7's mannequin. And yeah. Alright, looks pretty fitting with the mannequin, to be honest. It's black. So yeah. Alrighty. If that's the outfit that you guys voted for, then that's the outfit that 7 has decided to make. Now, last time we're gonna spin, because the other one's just gonna be for Mondo. It's either red or white, and that's for TVA. TVA has chosen the red. Yeah, the red mannequin. So TVA has chosen the red mannequin. We're gonna give the white one to Mondo. That's the one that belongs to him. And let's just create an outfit. There we go. This is everyday outfit. Let's go back to him. Okay, he's sitting down. Go back to TVA. And now let's see the outfit that, if you voted for TVA's outfit, then you most likely voted for this one. The red one. Alright, interesting. Honestly, it's actually a really interesting outfit. In my opinion. By the way, I'm not eligible to vote because I'm basically the host of this game, so my vote doesn't count. Or my opinions. They're just, They shouldn't impact anybody. But you guys get to choose whatever you want. And last but not least, we have Mondo, who will make his outfit right now with the yellow mannequin. So if you voted yellow mannequin, you probably gave Mondo the vote. Let's see. Create random outfit. Yes. I need to make sure that I'm doing this right. Let's see. This is Mondo's outfit. All right. Pretty nice, I would say. Alright guys, so these are the mannequins that you guys have voted for. These are the mannequins, and eventually I will know what, I will confirm like in a second, because this is editing, this is for the editing video, but eventually you'll find out who the winner is if you haven't figured it out already. But yeah, we'll get to those in a second. Alright everybody. Looks like our competition has been revealed to you, and now it's time to tell you who was the winner of the competition. So I have the results right here in my hand, and I will tell you who the winner is right now. Sound good? I think it looks great. Okay, so now you know that TVA is the red mannequin, Bontai is the yellow mannequin, 7 is the black mannequin, and Mondo is the white mannequin. Our winner of this competition is the red mannequin, meaning that congratulations, TVA, you are the winner of this HOH competition, meaning you are now our head of household. And don't pass out. And that does mean that you will move on to the final four. One more week for you, and you're closer to the finale. You just guarantee yourself a spot. You're entering the house. You're just like, all right, just some coffee. I've guaranteed yourself a spot in the finale and the final four, and it's up to you to shape which two people are gonna be put on the block. So congratulations, TVA. I will see you later at the HOH competition. All right, so this episode is gonna be a little bit longer. I'm gonna shorten it a little bit. If I keep filming, I need to shorten it a little bit. So I'm just gonna be really quick about this. But TVA is our HOH. I actually need to give her that. She's dancing with her mannequin. She's dancing with her fucking mannequin. I haven't taken that out. I need to take that out in a second. But she just... She's dancing with the mannequin. She really likes being the winner, huh? But that does mean that she is very powerful this week. So I would worry. I say that for everyone. I would worry, because this is still anybody's game. And this is also the last week where there will be a tie / tiebreaker, if there even is one. So this is very important as well, because if you guys end up having a tie, TVA will be the one like voting the competition out. After that, it's going to be like one contestant that gets to vote, and then the HOH gets the final say. So yeah, guys, can you believe Big Brother's about to end? Like, finally. Should have ended like a long time ago. But oh well. Okay, shit happens, you know? But yeah, TVA is our winner. And everybody else should worry, if I'm being totally honest. And yeah, I will leave it like right there. Because I said I was going to keep it short. So, we're leaving right there, and we're just going to skip straight towards the HOH competition. Not the competition, the HOH nominations. So, we'll see you guys after that. And, yeah, because after that, we're going to do the veto competition that you guys are also going to vote for. And we'll get to that when the time comes. So, brace yourself for that. Alright, everybody. This is the nomination ceremony. As you may know, TVA has won the power of HOH, and as one of her many duties, she has to choose two people up for eviction. She only has four options, but two of them... I forgot, press play. We're going to nominate two people still, and the game will go on as usual. With that being said, let's start with our first nominee. Our first nominee is... Mondo. Our second nominee is Seven. TV has nominated you, Mondo, and you, Seven. Seven, the reason why you're put up there is because you haven't been nominated since the very beginning. And, you know, there's got to be a first at some point. And it's your turn to be in the hot seat. It's been long overdue since you've been there. So it's time to feel the heat. Mondo, the reason why you're there is because apparently from the very beginning, you were just there for the convenience of TBA. Now that TVA doesn't need you anymore, you're basically disposable. That being said, this nomination ceremony is adjourned. All right, everybody, we're gonna skip right towards the veto competition, because you guys are gonna vote who's gonna be the best singer, but you're not gonna get it easy, you know? It's not like you're gonna get them performing and they're gonna be like, oh, this one's gonna win. Yeah, that one. Mm-mm-mm-mm. We're doing this Masked Singer style. Everybody in the fucking house is dressed up as the little character that I gave them, and we're gonna introduce them as they go. We're not gonna tell you who's behind the mask. You'll find out after the next episode when the voting's over. So, we're going to make them sing, and I'm gonna let you guys decide who do you think was the best singer out of the bunch, right? So, that being said, we're just gonna proceed with our first contestant, the hot dog.
Chobi Grombe, Chobi Prexabum, Exabe, Chobi Faru, Chobi Penef, Eben Jabu, Chobi Wom, Chobi Gorb, Chobi Grom, Dublina, Chobi Guam, Chobi Gord, Chobi Grom, Dublin, Chobi Grom.
All right, that was quite the performance done by the hot dog, and now we're going to present our second contestant of the competition, the Yeti.
Oh, Shabakashi Bodhi, Shalaz, Zubalapweeb, Shabuzan Zekofweeb, Shadi, Shabert, the name. Five, five, boobs. Whipskakisha, Dame the Bakasu, Burbe Boosta Mersta Boob, Dalbawa, Oshabashoob, Chabakashi Bloody, Chaza, Yblimsi Blunks, Yisheshubi, oh, Wally Maub, Shipskashla, Maybe Rob Rakasu. Pervade what a versa move, bow bow, I move on.
Alright, that was the Yeti, and now we're going to introduce our third contestant really quick, and it will be the robot.
Skip around a flick and chook. Wonka Fleeba Simola. Markle Shufla Brill. Whiffaloy be Brimnagand. Simsa Wixel Golga Vland. Nay Dune Turk Sizzin. Nay Dune Neblin. Nay Gra. As Nay be Fwa. Simsa Nay Sway. Wixel Golga Bland. Skip around a Durskin's Wat. Dada VP Cha Cha Bot. As Grosnizot. Oblissum Nervib Shady Gand. Simsa Wixel Golga Bland. Yee!
Quite the performance by the robot, and now we must introduce you to our next contestant called the raccoon.
It's a Beck Zebek Narsu, Hakibab Ribu, Wetzel Frepunchi Baru. And Chan Chiru! Wag wag, I'm the way, Exabay, Obizo, Wag Gom. Wag wag, Exabay, Obishe, Obizo, Bry, I. Imbic, Wag, Stroke, Break, Wag, Wag, Nope, Bozai, Gom! Greg, Exhibit, Obache, Gobi, Zobrai. Well, hey! Wow! Oh, yeah!
And that was our raccoon, and we have our final contestant right now. And it's going to be our last performance of the competition. And we're just going to introduce you to the panda.
We're snakes, the sipping eyes of Wexel, the sipping eyes of Blythe, the Merzifon of Wexel, a toffee Dwight. Again, she do fly. Walk a coonie be blind. The risk of your brick be by. One bond of three dark. Thirsty nipping flu guy. Bond of three dark. Cousin nipping flu guy. We're stranger, we're stranger. Walking a hot for fly. Wet slainer, wet slainer, even if you desire.
All right, everybody, that's the end of the competition. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. You guys get to decide who you guys are gonna vote for. Who was your favorite performer? Would it be the hot dog, the yeti, the robot, the raccoon, or the panda? Who was your favorite out of the bunch? Go out and vote. You only have a couple of days to do so. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I love you so much. I will see you guys in the next episode. Take care.